Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 74th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 59.
One. Ignition. And lift off of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1093, then landed successfully for the third time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. On Wednesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 75th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1018.
One. Ignition. And lift off. Go Starlink, go SpaceX.
The booster which launched this mission, B1090, then landed successfully for the fifth time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Landing leg deploy.
This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a few Falcon launches. The first of these, the Transporter 14 mission, is currently scheduled for today, Sunday 22nd at 10:18 PM UTC or 6:18 PM EDT. Then tomorrow we can hopefully expect to see a Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1023 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 23rd at 6:25 AM UTC or 2:25 AM EDT. A couple of days after that and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1034 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 25th at 6:32 AM UTC or 2:32 AM EDT. There was an article posted about SpaceX working with the Space Force on a satellite network. It says the Space Force is contracting with SpaceX for a new government-owned, contractor-operated satellite communication constellation in low Earth orbit called Milnet. Heading to Boca Chica, work continues on the Orbital Launch Pad 2 launch site. Work also continues on the chopstick arms for the orbital pad 2 tower. SpaceX are currently building a sidewalk along the highway by the launch site. Work continues with the groundwork for the gigabay. SpaceX continue to build out the new housing area at Starbase. On Tuesday, SpaceX posted a video of a single engine static fire of Starship 36 which was preparing for flight 10. You've likely already seen it, but during the week, the Flight 10 Starship, Starship 36, exploded during the static fire test. Thanks to NSF, here's a frame by frame of the explosion happening. After the static fire test failure, SpaceX posted some information. They said on Wednesday, June 18th at approximately 11 PM Central Time, the Starship preparing for the 10th flight test experienced a major anomaly while on the test stand at Starbase. A safety clear area around the site was maintained throughout the operation and all personnel are safe and accounted for. Our Starbase team is actively working to save the test site and immediate surrounding area in conjunction with local officials. SpaceX later posted an update on their website with more information about the failure cause. They said initial analysis indicates the potential failure of a pressurized tank known as a COPV or composite overwrapped pressure vessel containing gaseous nitrogen in Starship's nose cone area, but the full data review is ongoing. There is no commonality between the COPVs used on Starship and SpaceX's Falcon 9 rockets. Musk also posted confirming similar information about the failure. He said preliminary data suggests that a nitrogen COPV in the payload bay failed below its proof pressure. If further investigation confirms that this is what happened, it is the first time ever for this design. A section of booster 18 was seen being moved into Mega Bay 1 for stacking. As always, I have to say thanks to Jack Beyer, Cesar Garcia and Jerry Pike for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.